Hi everybody, Sean Delman here. Welcome to your Walkthrough Wednesday. This is episode number 4. In this video, I'll be showing you a few simple tips for using Microsoft Notepad. You've probably seen Notepad and used it before. This is what it looks like. Notepad was originally released in the 80s, and it hasn't changed much since that time. It's a simple text editor that can be used for many different functions. Tip 1. One of the major benefits of Notepad is that it's a very small and simple program, data-wise. That means that it loads very quickly, and in my experience, it almost never crashes. The same can't be said for larger, more complex programs like Word, Outlook, or OneNote. On numerous occasions, I've been the victim of Murphy's Law, and I've been on a call or in a meeting with a client, and I've had a problem with Microsoft Office, which prevented me from taking notes. Software screws up sometimes, and this happens, but when it happens during a client meeting, it's more of a big deal. So whenever this happens, and I can remember it happening a few times, as a backup, I open Notepad and start taking my notes there. Notepad is always responsive and it opens quickly. It saved my butt on a few occasions. To launch Notepad, I press the Windows logo key, and then I type Notepad, and then I press Enter. Typically, the first thing that I do is save the file in an easy-to-find location, such as in the My Documents or Downloads folder. Because Notepad doesn't come with a lot of bells and whistles, you need to be careful to save it and ensure that you don't lose your data. It doesn't have an autosave feature like the newer versions of Microsoft Office products, and it only has a few undo, redo save states. For example, in Microsoft Word, I can type some text, and then I can type some more text, and when I want, I can use Ctrl-Z and the Ctrl-Y shortcuts to undo and redo what I've done. I can go back and forth using these shortcut keys to undo and redo my work. Although there's a limit, Microsoft Windows and other Office products typically keep a large number of save states. This is not the case at all with Notepad. In general, Notepad only allows one save state. This means that if you type something and then delete it, you won't be able to get it back using the undo command. So my advice is that when you're using Notepad, treat it with care. Save often and don't delete any of your notes unless you're certain that you want to delete it or you're certain that you have the data saved in some other location. You don't want to leave a meeting with a client and realize that you're missing information. Tip 2. If I'm ever entering a lot of data into a web page or online portal, I never type the text directly into the web page. Why? Because websites sometimes crash or they screw up when it's time to send the data. I remember that I was once writing a lot of text into an online application, and when I clicked the submit button, there was an error with the web page and all of my text was gone. From that day forward, I vowed to never type text directly into a web page again, and I always first type it into a saved Notepad file, and then I copy the text over to be safe. Tip 3. Another benefit of using Notepad is that it supports only text, not images. Why is this helpful? This is helpful because sometimes the text is all you want. For example, in recent years, I've noticed that there are more and more websites that will allow you to look at a page for a few seconds as a teaser, but then a pop-up will come up and prevent further reading. When this happens, I use Notepad as part of a workaround. I reload the page by pressing F5, or you can click the reload button, and then I quickly press Ctrl-A and Ctrl-C when the web page comes up. The Ctrl-A command will select everything on the page, and the Ctrl-C command will copy it into your clipboard. Once I have the data copied, I open Notepad and then press Ctrl-V to paste the data. I now have the contents of the web page without the images, and I can read the text without a pop-up stopping me. I can also achieve this effect in Word or other Office products by using the Keep Text Only Paste option, but Notepad is still the faster, easier solution. One of the greatest things about Notepad files is that they're basically the smallest and fastest files that you'll ever use in Windows. Because it's a no-frills piece of software, you need to treat it with care, save often, and don't rely on the undo command to be sure that you don't shoot yourself in the foot and lose data. However, used correctly, Notepad is a zippy and reliable little friend that may just do the trick for solving a problem or problems that you encounter every so often. With that, thank you for watching this video. If you liked it and found it to be helpful, please like this post, leave a comment, follow me, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have an idea for a future Walkthrough Wednesday video and you'd like a walkthrough on something that you don't know how to do, please get in touch with me. Stay tuned for next week's video in which I'll be showing you how to use Microsoft Office Picture Manager. Microsoft stopped supporting this software circa 2013, but in my opinion, the software that they put in place isn't nearly as good. Thank you again. I'm Sean Dillman with Waythorn Legal Tech Training.